Richard Martinez here, about to share something with you that will change your life. This is one of the tools that's in my book, The Life Mastery System. This is a monthly planner, agenda, coach, tool, all kinds of different things that this helps you to do. So one of the tools, one of the pages in this book, it's how to connect and how to communicate with anyone. And that's what I'm about to share with you right now. But let's just think of the value of that. You know, what would it do for you in your life if you knew how to connect and communicate with anyone, everyone? If you understand how this works, how people work, how to connect with people, how to make them feel safe, how to bring down their defenses, you know, not to push their triggers, their buttons, or allow them to push yours. When you understand all these different things, you just become more effective in communicating and connecting with people. And when you are more effective in communicating with people, what does that do for you? Man, it just hires the quality of your life overall, because everything you do is based around people. So if you want to hire the quality of your life, you hire the quality of your relationships and you'll better your life. So how are you going to better the quality of your relationships? By bettering the quality of your communication with them, right? So that's what we're going to be talking about today. It doesn't matter their background, age, what industry they're in, what they believe, what they value, what their goals are. It doesn't matter. You will be able to connect and communicate with anybody by using this simple and practical tool in every encounter. And if you use it, I promise you, it will change your life. It will change your marriage. It'll change your parenting. It'll change, you know, your relationship with your clients. It'll grow your business. Like, your life will just upgrade, upscale, level up in every area because you apply this very simple tool and technique when it comes to relationships. Because thinking is asking yourself a question and then answering it yourself, right? Think about it. That's what thinking is. You ask yourself a question and then your brain pulls up all the information that it knows and it answers it for you, right? So that's this inward conversation. So if we want to better our thinking, we got to better the kind of questions we're asking ourselves. Because then we're gonna pull up better information from our brains to have better solutions and better results and a better future, right? It all starts here in the brain. So we wanna ask ourselves the right question, especially when it comes to this one tool that I'm gonna share with you of how to connect and communicate with anybody. Now, here's the question I want you to ask every time you're gonna have an encounter, you're gonna have a conversation with anybody. It doesn't matter if it's gonna be just for a couple minutes, a couple hours, the whole day. You know, if it's somebody that you've been with for years already and you already know them, I want you to just train your brain to ask this one question, because if you learn how to ask this question every time you're gonna have a conversation, it'll help you to set yourself up, all your tone, your energy, everything, to be in alignment with this person, and you're gonna cause more agreement. You're gonna just set yourself up for them to feel more comfortable around you, and you know how valuable that is? You see, people trust, you trust yourself the most. People trust themselves the most, right? Think about it. They feel most comfortable around themselves. So if we want to create influence with these people, if we want to make them feel safe, we want to make them feel loved, whatever it is, we first need to bring down their defenses. And the way we bring down their defenses is making them feel understood, because they feel safest around themselves, right? So when we can make them feel understood, and the way we do that is by getting ourselves to kind of match them, like getting ourselves to match their energy, their tone, their body language, their facial expression, because now all of a sudden you're similar to them, you're like them, you're familiar. So they feel safe, their defenses go down, they open up more, you're able to connect, you create influence, you can do anything you want with that influence now. So that's the power of this tool. So it just starts off by you asking the question of, are they inward or are they outward? Are they inward or are they outward? This is the question I want you to get trained to ask every time you have somebody walking up to you and you're gonna have a conversation. You're gonna ask, is this person inward or outward? And I'm gonna tell you what that means now. So inward, introverted. Outward, extroverted. Inward, slower reply, lower energy, right? You can identify an inward introverted person. The way they stand, the way they walk, or the way they talk is a little bit more sensitive, more calm, cool, and collected, right? Lower energy. The way they're walking, the way they're, you know, reading things, the way they put things down, it's a lower, you know, energy, right? The way they walk, the way they talk, everything's a little bit slower reply. If you ask them a question, they're gonna think about it a little bit more. They're not gonna just jump on it with a lot of energy, right? On the other end, you have the outward the extroverted, so when they're doing things, they're more, they have a higher energy, whether it's like a strong, like results oriented one, or more of a happy, you know, higher energy, and when they walk, or you know, when they're walking, they're getting somewhere. Either way, that's a higher energy, right? When you ask them a question, boom, they have a reply, an answer right away, right? They think as they're saying. They're the external processors. These are the outward types of people. So you can identify these two already. You can identify how they would dress, right? I know it's like a general thing, but how would an extroverted person dress? You know, they would dress a little bit more loud as well, right? You know, maybe, you know, the type of personality that's more of a center of attention type of personality, and they're wearing bright colors, big accessories to call attention, right? To attract. You know, these are a different type of energy. That's an extroverted person, right? The ones who are in the groups and they laugh the loudest, talk the loudest, you know, you can hear them out of that group. They're the ones who have a higher energy, right? You can notice by the way they talk, by the way how they dress, you know, even by what kind of car they buy sometimes. So if you pay attention, everybody's giving clues so that you can identify, is this person, what's the question? Inward or outward? Is this person introverted or extroverted? So do this right away. Like if you have a client, if you have a business, you're an entrepreneur, you have a client that's gonna come into your office, watch them get out of the car and you'll be able to identify already by asking the question, okay, are they inward or are they outward? And look at them getting out of the car, how they get out of the car, how they walk, how they're dressed, you know, how they're, you know, how they're presenting themselves. All these things are giving you clues to answer the question that you just asked yourself, are they inward or outward? Because now that you can identify, oh, this person's more outward, now you can set yourself up to mirror and match them, which is the next part, to mirror and match them, so that way you can create that familiar environment, remember? Because they feel safest around themselves. They trust themselves the most. So if you understand that concept, you create a space in your interaction with them, in this encounter with them, that feels familiar to them. So that way you're not messing with all these defenses that they have up because they're trying to read you and try to deal with your differences and your personality, that some of the things that they don't really like or comfortable around. So they're kind of, you have to deal with those things. And if you use this technique, you bring those things down a lot faster, make them feel safe with you, trust you, and now you create influence and you've connected with them. And you can use that influence for anything, right? So ask the question, are they inward or outward? You know, I have a whole course where I teach on each personality. Like this is just like the surface of it, right? Like just asking the question of how you're gonna approach. Then I teach in detail how to identify inward or outward. How to mirror and match, what does that mean in detail? I do practices, you know, exercises, different things to show you how to mirror and match these different personalities, because it's very simple, but we don't really, it's common sense, but it's not common practice. And you're not gonna benefit until you actually do this. So I want you to start to do this. Ask the question, is this person inward or outward? Okay, so now that you ask the question, your brain's gonna start to, you know, look for it, right? Now you're gonna start to see, okay, this person's inward. So what do you do now? So you ask the question, inward or outward? Now that you know, you can identify, right? Now you mirror and match. So mirror, what does a mirror do? A mirror reflects your physical body, right? So if I, it's like right now, this camera is like mirroring me, right? It's videotaping me. So it's like this. But match means matching the energy. So mirroring, you're going to mirror their physical body, and match is matching their energy. That's what you're gonna do. So once you ask that question, okay, is this person inward or outward? You answer that question, okay, they're outward. Now you mirror and match. So you're not, so whether you're inward or outward doesn't matter. You're going to mirror and match. You focus on them. Okay, so they're more outward. By the looks at it, they're more friendly. They're more talkative and more social. Okay, so I'm going to be that right now for this beginning of this connection, because I want to bring down their defenses. I want them to feel safe very fast so I can build that trust very fast, so I can have that influence very fast. Okay, so I mirror and match. So maybe I'm not usual, you know, fun, friends, and freedom. Maybe I'm usually very introverted. Oh, I'm not really like that, Richard. That's okay. That's to create influence very fast. I'm telling you, this is gonna better your connection, better your influence with everyone in your life. And if you train yourself to do this with every connection, you're going to win. You're gonna have favor, doors will open, you'll get promotions. People will just want you around because you become more attractive. You become more powerful, influential, because people just feel understood by you all the time. I'm telling you, this is very powerful stuff, and it's very simple. Ask the question, is this person inward or outward? Now, if they're inward, right? Okay, you asked yourself, okay, this person's inward. What do? You mirror match. Very simple. So maybe you're normally high energy, right? Or you may be very, you know, like driven, and you just result and you just go for it. And now you got this personality that's more sensitive and just calm, cool, and collected and patient, and they don't want to be pushed. But you're that type of personality that's just going like this, right? So if you don't mirror and match, they're not going to feel safe around you. You break that connection, you break that influence, and that can create other problems. But if you are normally aggressive and assertive, and that's who you are, doesn't mean you need to change that. But it's that beginning of those encounters, of those interactions, that you need to adjust so that you can bring their defenses down, create the trust, make them feel understood, and then you can start to bring out more, because now they feel safe already, right? But if you get good at this, you can do it very fast. So if I'm going to mirror and match, if I'm usually very strong energy, and this is a more inward, calm, cool, and collected energy, I'm going to mirror and match. Mirror the body language and match the energy. If you do this with every interaction, with your kids, with your spouse, your partner, with clients, you can do this over the phone. You can identify if they're inward or outward over the phone by just listening to their voice, to their tone, their questions. And now you just begin to adjust yourself because you asked the question. This is the most powerful question. Is this person inward or outward? So remember, this is one of the tools in the Life Mastery System. I'm Richard Martinez. Hope you enjoyed this. Comment, make sure you're following, share this with somebody, because this is a tool that will change people's lives. So thank you guys, appreciate it.